Great work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. We're leading our teammate by 1.8 seconds. Okay, keep on him. He might make a mistake. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the hards. No need to worry about tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good. Okay, the gap behind is 4.1 seconds. We're going to box this lap, push hard on the in-lap. The car behind has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. Complete, go now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Valtteri is in for his stop. Gap to teammate behind is 4.7 seconds. we're leading our teammate by 7.3 seconds. Yellow flag. Be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. Okay, clear. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Gap to teammate behind is 13.2 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. There's four laps of fuel remaining. Fantastic drive, just fantastic. You deserved that race win.
And that's it then for the Portuguese Grand Prix. And what a sensational victory they've managed to pull off here. Ant, talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. Let's have a quick look at how the driver standings have changed. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Let's focus on the driver of the day, Anthony Davidson,